Before the exploration of space, of the moon and the planets, man held that the heavens were the home and province of powerful gods who controlled not just the vast firmament, but the earthly fate of man himself. And that the pantheon of powerful warring deities was the cause and reason for the human condition, for the past and the future, and for which great monuments would be created on earth as in heaven. But in time, man replaced these gods with new gods and new religions that provided no more certain or greater answers than those worshipped by his Greek or Roman or Egyptian ancestors. And while we've chosen now our monolithic and benevolent gods and found our certainties in science, believers all, we wait for a sign, a revelation. Our eyes turn skyward, ready to accept the truly incredible, to find our destiny written in the stars. But how do we best look to see, with new eyes or old?
Protecting me or protecting yourself?
Why should that surprise you? Motives are rarely unselfish.
What kind of business are you in?
We predict the future. The best way to predict the future is to invent it. We predict the future. The best way to predict the future is to invent it. Good day, young lady. You've made us wait.
It was a weather delay on the shuttle from Washington.
You had business there?
Yes. May have already heard.
We've heard you acted on your own and moved the salvage UFO to another location.
These new attempts to recover it have increased our need for security.
Who else is looking for it?
In the event, I moved it as a safeguard.
Somebody better damn well find out how the French even knew where to look for it.
I can assure you it'll be absolutely inaccessible now.
Why not bring it to Nevada, like the others?
Leaks in security and a heightened public interest have made the base in Nevada unviable. Is this why I was called here?
No. We'd like an explanation about this business with the assistant director of the Bureau, Skinner.
Random shooting, for all I know.
They have a waitress who's given a description of the shooter. They released a composite of his face to the press. One of yours, isn't he?
To tell you. If he did, he acted on his own.
Good Lord.
If he did, he acted on his own.
Good Lord.
This is a very serious exposure for us.
I'll take care of it.
My advice to you, sir, is to understand the priorities here. Get this shooter out of the country as quickly as possible. If the assistant director IDs him, our well-placed operatives won't be able to stand in the way of an arrest. Compromising beyond repair the secrecy of our work and the security, as you so arrogantly assert, of our project's future.
It'll be handled.
Mr. Mulder, can we meet somewhere?
Oh, I would love to.
Give your phone number to my assistant. He'll call you back in 5 minutes. I'll meet him in 3 hours in Central Park, near the lighted walkway off 79th, near the reservoir. When you hang up, have this number disconnected.
I trust we're alone.
We're all alone in New York City, sir.
You're looking for Alex Krycek.
To kill him. In revenge.
What makes you think we haven't done that already?
What for?
Tell me what you know, and I'll consider giving you Krycek.
Now, you answer a few questions for me first, like what was pulled off the bottom of the Pacific Ocean.
It was a UFO, a so-called Foo Fighter, downed by American fighter pilots in the Second World War.
Left there until now?
There were salvage attempts. A U.S. sub was sent in 50 years ago, but there were complications.
Almost the entire crew died.
Yeah. It's still a mystery.
A mystery to whom?
The cover story said it was the third A-bomb bound for Japan. But the truth is, no one knows what killed that crew.
I know.
Do you know?
You give me Krycek and I'll tell you.
Mr. Mulder, I've given you so much this evening. You've offered me next to nothing in return.
You haven't told me anything I didn't already know.
I'm curious. If you've encountered Krycek, why didn't you kill him then?
Because he has the tape.
Ah, yeah. The tape.
The tape he's been selling those secrets off. You don't know where he is either, do you? You're looking for him too.
Mr. Mulder, anyone can be gotten to. Certainly you've no doubt of that. You've been putting on the miles.
It would help if you had a phone.
I come out here because there are no phones.
What is it? A courier is dead.
Yes, I heard. Pushed out a window. Can this expose us?
No, of course not. Our necessary and plausible denial is intact.
What is your concern?
Last night, CIA airport intel had a man using UN credentials appear on their computers. Booked on a flight for Krasnoyarsk, Russia.
Who was it?
We haven't been able to determine that with any certainty as yet, but it appears to be a man fitting the description of Fox Mulder. We haven't been able to determine that with any certainty as yet, but it appears to be a man fitting the description of Fox Mulder.
You fool, you stupid fool. This must be corrected, this must be handled.
Well, of course it can be. You know my capabilities in a crisis.
I don't think you realize what's at stake here. What level this must be carried to. This will take more than just a good aim.
We haven't been able to determine that with any certainty as yet, but it appears to be a man fitting the description of Fox Mulder. Vasily Peskov. He was a KGB line-X stringer working out of Moscow Center.
But how could this be? How could the Russians know we're working on our own inoculation? Six of us knew.
Dr. Karnsere?
She was trusted. Absolutely.
Then I don't know.
Find this man. Find him.
My intelligence sources are right. I think there's someone who might save us the trouble.
Facial scarrings appear to be self-mutilation. Done as protection.
Protection against what?
Infection by the black oil.
Protection against what?
Infection by the black oil.
Protection against what?
Infection by the black oil. He was the lone survivor of a crashed spacecraft at a military base in West Virginia.
What the hell is he?
An alien rebel. This is what the boys saw in Russia. The last face the dead saw at Skyland Mountain. And most surely, who killed our man at the dam in Pennsylvania. He's a resistance fighter against the alien colonists.
What good was that knowledge? Without the vaccine against the black oil, no one can survive.
We have a vaccine. What this means, resistance is possible. We have the weapons and the magic in hand.
We don't know the vaccine works.
It will. And if it doesn't, we have a new alliance to be made. But first, wait till we know the
vaccine works.
The vaccine has no effect.
But first, wait till we know the vaccine works.
The vaccine has no effect.
We must give it time.